Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him two lips like roses and clover. Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over. Sandman, I'm so alone. Don't have nobody to call my own. Please turn on your magic beam. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him the word that I'm not a tell him that his lonesome nights are over, Sandman. I'm so alone, don't have nobody to call my own. Please turn on your magic beam, Mr. Sandman, bring me a
Hi, my name's Mark A. Marple. Welcome to Lincoln Theater. Every day I ask my students to write down an inspirational quote off the whiteboard that I put down for them. And I want them to write a sentence about what it means to them. This one particular is from Orson Welles, the author of Citizen Kane. If you want a happy ending, that depends on where you stop your story. Even superheroes have to do their homework. Write it on the discussion board. Thank you.
Good morning, class. Today we're going to be doing a summary of Lawrence Kohlberg's stages of moral development. Now, this is a little bit off the beaten path of what I usually do in regards to theater and film, but today we're going to investigate and get the foundations in the short time that we have of what Kohlberg thought were the six stages of moral development from infancy into adult. And then also, we're going to look and see how that's used in film today. So, no further ado, you're not going to be able to see this very well, so let's go to the PowerPoint.
Kohlberg's theory of moral development. Jean Piaget's theory was released in 1936 and inspired Lawrence Kohlberg's theory several decades later in 1958. Now, who is Jean Piaget? Well, Piaget's theory of cognitive development explains how a child constructs a mental model of the world. Kohlberg's theory of moral development stated that people progressed in their moral reasoning, an example in their basis for ethical behavior, through a series of stages. An example that he would use is the Heinz dilemma. Heinz was a story that Kohlberg used in his studies where a man, Heinz, lives in a village with a wife who has a special kind of cancer. She is dying, and Heinz has heard of a drug that can cure her that was developed by the local pharmacist. The radium used to make the drug costs $200, but the pharmacist is charging $2,000 and won't come down on his price. Heinz borrows from everyone that he can, but only comes up with $1,000. The pharmacist says that it's not enough, and he won't take a payment plan. Heinz is desperate and breaks into the pharmacy and steals the drug for his wife. Was he morally right? In these six stages that Heinz has, he explains the differences between the level or stage, the age range, and then gives a description. The beginning stage of infancy was where the infant didn't know right from wrong, but would begin to avoid certain behaviors because, they didn't want to get punished. This is level one, pre-conventional morality, and stage one, obedience and punishment. I will do what you want and not grab the cookies out of the jar because I don't want to get slapped. Level one, pre-conventional morality, stage two is individualism and exchange. Well, there's not more than one right view, isn't there? I mean, there is more than one right. I have in my opinion, too. I want to avoid being punished, but that doesn't mean you're right. Level 2, conventional morality. Stage 3, good interpersonal relationships. This is when, usually in the teen years, where the students want to be good and they want to do the right thing. In stage 4 of level 2, maintaining the social order, maintaining the laws and respecting authority and looking to help society as a whole. As you can see, these teens are working together to benefit society. Level 3, post-conventional morality. Stage 5, social contract and individual rights. Well, the right society might hold an examination of morality over rules or laws, questioning what is in place. Well, voting is a way to change or to examine the rules or regulations and to help create it. Level 3, post-conventional morality. Stage 6, universal principles. It's a conception of justice and civil disobedience is developed here. Martin Luther King argued that laws are only valid insofar as they are grounded in justice, and that a commitment to justice carries with it an obligation to disobey unjust laws. But again, that is civil disobedience. This is your homework assignment. After going through these 6 stages with you, I want you to show me a movie example. Write it on a blog in the discussion board. A film that has a moral dilemma similar to Heinz. And explain your reasoning, and it should be a minimum of 150 words. The example I have here is the wonderful Denzel Washington in the movie John Q. Recently, I was blessed to be cast in a F.C. Rabath movie called The Board. And it closely aligns itself to the Heinz story. This international award-winning film, it's a short, is on next. Enjoy.
Says.
Yeah, well, I'd rather bet on you, sweetheart.
Denial's always been cute on you. Sean, please don't get back into this.
You know we need the money. You know how much these meds cost.
Sean, please listen to me.
Discount, though, on my wife's meds. We do appreciate that.
It's my pleasure. There's more to the pharmaceutical industry than the profiteering of boogeymen you see on TV. We're healers.
So, what's the job?
Dr. Rick Bishop. Top priority, shoot to kill. He's robbing us blind. He knows the angles.
He's a bad person.
That guy's an abuser, a loser, a boozer, and a user. What? I like old movies. He's trying to bankrupt us, Sean. And you know who always wins those fights? The lawyers. We think we can settle this another way. And maybe get back to exploring some options for your wife?
listen to me. There are lives at stake here, okay?
You're just a thief. You're just gonna say what they always say.
Didn't steal anything, really. Look, would you just listen to me for just a second, please?
That's what they always say.
Didn't steal anything.
No, okay. Hey, look. They're using you. Nikki Queen, right? Right? The raven hair, the piranha smile, right? Do you know her?
What do you know about that?
Dichloroacetate. It's the key to the cure for cancer. And it's cheap, and it's efficient, and it's unpatentable. You see, it means the drug companies will be losing billions.
But you stole classified information.
Oh, no, I'm not a thief, and I'm not a criminal. You see, I'm just a guy who thinks he's on a cure, okay? So you can take me to a hospital, or you can let me die for their profits.
Assuming you got the job done.
I hope I will. I just haven't shot the bad guy yet.
Character had a moral dilemma very similar to Heinz. His wife was dying of cancer. Barely could he afford, without becoming that hitman again, the money that it took from the pharmacy, or the pharmaceutical company in this case, that he needed to do one last hit. However, he finds, as you know, the cure for cancer. And then he decides to take out the true enemy. This is an example that Kohlberg used for his theory of moral development. What do you think? What I'd like to see you do is look throughout history and look through the films, some of the films that you might have seen, such as John Q with Denzel Washington. And where are their similarities? Where did this get inserted into the plot line? Please go to the discussion board. Go ahead and write your discussion on this in the blog. And we'll see you in the next class where we further go deeper into the theory of moral development by Kohlberg.